I don't know who the fuck she is either. This is my first ever Get Ready With Me. You guys, I transformed into Insta baddie. I was supposed to just be like, oh, my cute every day. Yeah, girl, this one I wear every day. Nah, suddenly sis put in fucking Luxe, synthetic ass, fucking hair extensions, fucking blew out her hair, pressed it from Mother Teresa herself. I'm kind of obsessed. Okay, I just wanted to do a quick Get Ready With Me. Just my everyday makeup. I have this on my IG highlights, but I think YouTube deserved a version and I wanted to put it up here, and I just want to be more consistent with YouTube videos. I'm so ready to stop being a little bitch about this. So I'm on YouTube. I'm here, bitches. Let's go. Let's rock and roll. This makeup look is geared towards lazy girls. If you don't really want to be doing that much, but you want to look the most. Let me taste it. These are clip-in extensions from Insert Name Here. This is the cute lounge set from Fashion Nova. If you want to see this transformation, honey, stay the fuck tuned. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please let me know if you want more. Please harass me online, or else I won't do it. So, why I'm getting ready today. Okay, I need to be taking really cute photos. I want to take really cute photos. The variables. Okay, girl, we busted down this mane. Okay, she's straightened for the first time in a minute. Okay, so we added clip-in extensions. Okay, so this is new for us. Whatever, we're gonna make it work. Anyways, and then I have bitch press-on nails. These nails are from Treshy, treshy.com. They were so sweet, and they sent me a whole box of all these cute-ass designs, colors, and they come in this shape, but I actually shape them more down to like a little bit, a little bit more of an almond shape, and they're so cute. I'm gonna be wearing these all quarantine. Like, literally, the nail shop is closed. What am I supposed to do? The nail shop is closed. Like, not for real. Like, you know, when this apocalypse outside, it's synthetic extensions and press-on nails. That's what we're doing. We're making it look cute, ladies. So I'm gonna show you how to be quarantine. Fake bougie. Okay, I wear this look all the time, but it's because I'm actually essentially lazy and this look is so easy, so I'm gonna fucking show you. I wear this look all the time. Y'all are probably tired of my, like, do something different, and I'm like, no, I can't. I'm giving you something different with the hair today, so just let me breathe. Okay, we're moving on. I didn't cite the jewelry in my sources. This necklace, my name, all this. These two are from Vibe Season. And then these earrings and this chain, this single chain, is from Wolf Circus. These rings are all Adidas jewels. So I'll also tag them as well. So I'm gonna be using, she's seen her days, she's traveled. This is my dear friend, Faces by Rob on Instagram. His fucking makeup line. I use this mirror all the time when I travel. This is like, just like, the best. Like, I just, it goes on the road with me. So I actually came out with blushes, a bronzer, a lip liner, lip gloss. Like, he is just everything. So okay, so I'm gonna be using this mirror. Just don't judge. Sorry, I got caught up in my reflection. So usually how I start when I'm being super lazy and just quick on the go is I prep with Max Fix Plus. If I'm just trying to be super fast, quick on the go, it's a spritz. So this is my before and after. Lazy girl secrets. But I do run out of this shit constantly. Like, at the MAC store, like, they know me. I'm like, girl, I'm back. They're like, okay, we got you. They be enticing you with like the other flavors and stuff. You guys know what I mean? Like, the different flavored, like, girl, I got the white tea one. It was so good, but I can't keep up. This is the best one though. I really believe in this one. So I'm just gonna spritz all over my face really quick. It's like really refreshing. So hydrate me. Okay, next up. Then I'm gonna go in with my Dose of Colors concealer in the color Light Medium 14. I am obsessed with this concealer. It's really hard for me to find like a really light concealer that still has yellow undertones. Like, this shit is fucking yellow. Like, I need yellow. I'm breaking out some acne scars a little bit of discoloration. So I'm kind of just concentrating all this product here, like in the lower parts of my face. So I'm gonna use my finger, my ring finger, my middle finger, and blend this out. And I'm not gonna bring the under eye concealer on my eyelid at all. I'm actually just gonna leave that naked until later. That was one swipe. That was pretty good. And I'll just go in with like a little bit more if I want. I do have redness around my nose today, especially. And just any extra discoloration I see. I really like this tool because I can outline my lips. It just makes it really precise. My base is probably the most important part of my entire routine. It takes the longest. I spend the most time on my base, and it's for a damn good reason why. Because I want that shit to be porcelain perfection, show-stopping, dramatic. Well, we get compliments, so. No, I'm kidding. People don't understand your humor, Michaela, yet. Like, chill, give them a second. I use powder foundation because I'm so oily. I will drip through every liquid, nothing. I cannot wear liquid foundation for the life of me, so I stick to concealer and powder foundation. So I use one light color that is gonna be like my inside color, and I use one darker color to be my outside color, kind of giving that contourish effect, but still like airbrush looking, which I can achieve with the motherfucking powders. I've been using these literally since I was 16 years old. I've tried other products in the past, and I am always open to trying new products, but I just find myself constantly gravitating back. These are just like, forever. Like, you can't discontinue this, Mac, come on. I'll start a riot if you discontinue these. Come on now, we need you. Like, that's why I can trust them. So I'm gonna show you how I achieve like an airbrushed contoured look. So I'm going in with my lighter color NC30, and I'm using this Real Techniques brush. You can find these at Target, anywhere. And I'm kind of starting just right under my eye and pushing the product into my skin. So, kind of like this. I notice when I use this type of brush that's that detailed and then push it into the skin, it like fills the pores and makes you look like you have no pores, like literally blurred out, like literally like, and I'm holding it like a talon, like I'm literally holding it like a crazy person because that means it works. So now I'm going in with a bigger fluffy brush this way, and I'm going in with my darker color. This is NC45, and I'm tapping it on here. So I'm starting on the top of my cheekbone, and literally, you guys, press on, press method, press. I said this on my IG highlight too, like press, press, press. Cardi don't need no stress. Like, on its side to go against my hairline so I can create shape and dimension. Sorry, I'm reading an email. Okay, just kind of blending it all over my face, like lightly, like incorporating it into our first color. With our powder foundations, it can get really, really muddy. As you can see, like, it's not a straight line, like it looks muddy. So it's our due diligence, it's our job, it's our right, sis. Our diligence as citizens to go back in and fucking blend that shit out. So I take a dry beauty blender and just cut the fuck out of my cheeks. And I go from my ear, kind of, and I help you find the lines like this. So this is my our first initial powder foundation color. I learned this shit from RuPaul's Drag Race. They be cutting up their cheeks and it looks so good. So this is like kind of baking, but not really baking. And this is a good opportunity if you want to reinforce your bright under eye to just like pat that shit fucking with all the powder you can. So basically, like, this is why the base takes so long, because sis, she's a mosaic. She takes pieces, goes back, edits, pieces, goes back, edits. It's all a masterpiece. So I want to re-blend all this out because I cut my cheeks and I reinforced my under eye that my bronzing section got kind of messed up. Even though we cut out our cheeks, trust me, listen to me. how we're gonna blend our face, how we're gonna mosaic our face even further is taking a little bit of a darker powder foundation, a darker color, whatever that you want that to be. That's gonna be like our bronzer color. So I wanna look really warm and yummy today. So take the Bite Pressed Powders. These are from Bite Beauty. They're so good. I love Bite Beauty. In the color medium too. And this is just like really yellow, really warm bronzer for me. I'm gonna take this fluffy kind of dummy mix brush and tap it in. Make sure I'm getting that off. And like how all this has got messed up, I'm gonna be working on that, reinforcing that area. But just a little bit of a darker. So I'm kind of like patting in this new warm cheek. Who told you to act that way? Yo, you guys, I'm just having a good time. It's sunny in LA. It's been hard with this quarantine shit, so the little victories, you guys. What I use for my eyebrows next after I do my base is I use this by MAC. Basically an eyebrow pen in the color Stylized, so it kind of goes on like, you see, so I can create flex with it. So I'm gonna be going in with a spoolie in this by MAC. So I brush my eyebrows up and out, and then I start in the middle, just kind of define them. And this makes it really easy because I just want control over the shape. I'm looking down into my mirror and I'm flecking my eyebrows up. I'm creating little hair strands so that it looks like bushy rabbit eyebrows, which I love. So we're gonna blend this out right now with a spoolie. I'm making these motherfuckers giant. Go back in with the Stylized pen and just any areas that like I felt like got a little bit too sparse, or I just like wanted to reinforce some shape, I'll go in there with that. So next for brows is the part that's so satisfying. This part is so satisfying. I take a little bit of it and I just brush them up with the mix of castor oil and got to be glue. So this is my secret trick, because the big brow movement, as you can see, can sometimes get very aggressive and very fucking out of hand. You can scare everyone around you. You can give everyone around you fucking secondhand embarrassment. I do it all the time, but not this time. So I'm gonna be real with myself. I'm gonna pinch my eyebrows. And be like, you know what? Shh. Chill out a little bit. It is me. This is beautiful. The next part is the P. Louise base. A makeup artist I recently worked with was so sweet and let me have one of her extras because I loved it so much. I was so beyond, I'm put away. I love this base. This is the bombest base I've ever used. Like, on, I'm being so fucking serious. It's shuts everything the fuck up. That's why I kept my eyelids clean this whole time. And then I rub it out with my fingers all over. And this also works as a concealer too. Do you see the difference that just made? I look so awake, and you don't have to set it with powder at all. It sets on its own, which is fucking bomb because I'm fucking lazy. Go in more with my base and a tiny detailed brush like this. This is also from Real Techniques, and pinch it so it's like very fine, and put a little bit of P. Louise base on it and carve out my eyebrows because I really like that really, really clean eyebrow look. And then just blend it out with my finger a little bit. posted on my Instagram story which pair should I put on, and you guys all voted for this pair. Literally so cute, and they're hard like acrylics, like they're fucking hard. Say her name too. I literally wear this look every day. I really like to look clean, finished, bomb, put together. Yes. So next part though is my favorite part. This is the Buxom blush in Mykonos. This is the Shea Mitchell collab. This is really pretty. It's like coral ass coral. I love, I need pink tangerine. Yes mama. So I'm going in with I can't even remember what type of brush this is, but it's like a small dome brush. So I'm starting right here. Okay. Slowly blending down my cheekbones, staying above here. I'm not gonna put blush anywhere down here. I'm focusing all right here. So it looks like the illusion that I have really, really high cheekbones. Like I kind of do a little bit, but I'm just making that shit fucking high as hell. It just makes me look so alive, so cute. I literally love this so much. I'm going back in with my bronzer kabuki brush just as reinforcement that I didn't get too pink or too crazy. After I feel like I'm pretty happy with my blush and like color back in my face and everything like that, really bright awake looking, I like to go in with lip liner next. So everyone knows I use Soar by MAC. This is my lip liner color, period. Dusty Rose, and I'm gonna go in with the Baby Sharpener. I'm gonna make sure that this is really, really crispy sharp for me. That is the key to a bomb line. That shit needs to be sharp, boo boo ka-choo. Yeah, no, do not play yourself. Okay, so I'm gonna cancel out my Cupid's bow and then overline ever so slightly and then taper off in this corner. So I'm not gonna bring it out. I'm gonna bring like a bow, like kind of like heart, under her. Does that make sense? So I'm just ever so lightly overlining my actual lip line. I'm seeing all the mistakes that I made a little bit, and I'm gonna be carving out my lip mistakes. So you can see one right here. So right now I'm pretty happy with my lip line, but I'm gonna blend it out even a little bit more. I'm gonna take a baby tiny lip brush and a little bit of MAC lip gloss. Instead of putting lip gloss on the entire lip and rubbing it in, when you take a little brush and apply it, I'm actually gonna be able to blend out my lip line, make it look juicier and plumper with this actually. So I'm gonna start here. So I'm pretty happy with my lip gloss, so we're gonna move on. So next, I take a big fluffy brush like this, that's shaped, a little shaped fluffy brush, and the Laura Mercier Indiscretion Gold Highlighter. This is like so pretty. Oh, this is gorgeous. So I take a little bit, and I take a little on my nose, tops of my cheekbone, and a little bit on my brow bone. So boo, we're right back where we started, baby. Fix Plus. So we're gonna set our entire face with Fix Plus. Now after setting our face, I would just go like this. Like I kinda like the baby doll look. Like I don't need lashes. Like I don't feel like I need lashes all the time, but I am gonna put on mascara today. So I'm gonna set my face with MAC Fix Plus. Drenched. Like literally wet. Don't move. Don't fucking move. Stop, drop, and roll. Don't move. While your face is setting, you're gonna wanna do your mascara. So while I'm waiting for my face to set, I'm gonna do my mascara in the mirror. Just so when you do your mascara last, it doesn't get all over everything else. It doesn't fuck up the whole show. So I don't even know how to say this. So we're gonna use a Dior Show Pump and Volume. This is really bomb. I really like this one. So I'm gonna take my mirror and look down into it.
and comb out my eyelashes up and out. And then I kind of push them to the corner of my eye to make it look like I wore eyeliner, but I didn't. Lazy bitch, I told you. So you can see Dior mascara. No, Bomb. Oh my god,
these are long. So now your face is pretty much set. Okay, I'm gonna go finish my hair and I'll be right back. I love this look. I'm just playing around with some clip-in extensions. I haven't straightened my hair in so long. These do not match my hair for shit, but I'm just playing around. Girl, I'm just trying to feel good about myself in this quarantine, honey. Thank you guys for watching. Yeah, this is just like a quick little cute get ready with me. I hope you guys loved it. I feel like such an Insta baddie. What the fuck? Honey, how do you guys wear this shit every day, girl? But I see why you hoes just be constantly like, I wanna be like that too. I wanna be like that. Please comment and subscribe what type of more videos you want to do. I think I'm going to do like a what's in my bag, a clothing try on, like all this random shit, more hair videos, more shit. You guys know I'm insane. So we're just going to keep it going. I'm bored during this quarantine, so we're just going to bust them out. Yeah, this is all my natural hair, just plus some clip-ins. That's crazy. Damn, that's wild, shorty. All right. I need to leave. Goodbye.